And thank you, Bangladesh Finland Chamber of Commerce and Industry. As MC has already told that I was the former president of the Dhaka Chamber of Commerce and Industry. And also I was the former president of Bangladesh IT Association. So serving these two chamber and association, I'm sure this now, I just represent myself as a founder and the chairman of the one private university. As I understood from the, all of this distinguished speaker, that Finland is one of the country that which is dominating to the education sector. And at the same time, you have a very fantastic domination and of course the good landmark in the IT and of course the health industry. So considering all of the aspects, and I know this, I have a presentation, but it's a wise to say some of my real experience, what exactly I know last 2 days about Finland and Bangladesh. A lot of the factor we are facing, a lot of the problems, especially the health sector. And you'll be surprised to know, considering the Bangladeshi population, India, Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia, these four countries, their main focus, their key focus to get the Bangladeshi people, especially in the health sector. And if I'm not wrong, this India is almost, I think, their 70% foreign currency in respect of health sector is coming from Bangladesh. And the same in Singapore. And you'll be surprised if you go to. So I should say, as a Consul General, you are already representing Bangladesh. And at the same time, the people, those who are sitting in front of me, I'm sure we can make a good place. So I think that because I already took over presentation, because as I understood a lot of these facts and figure, you already aware about it. I think our first secretary has already mentioned some of the facts. So I should say that what exactly we can do. Second, I think our Veronica, I think member of parliament, you already mentioned that you have a very good track record about the education sector. And Bangladesh is another, another opportunity, education sector. Because as I already mentioned, 170 million people, there is now 103, there is 103 private university, and very close to the 46 public university. So what happened? The people, you see, if you go back to the 20 years back, our literacy rate was very low. It's almost 25% to 27%. But now it's going to high. It's almost 45%. So what happened? The educational sector, I should say, is not up to the standard. Because as I'm also representing from the education sector, I always fighting with the government and all of the stakeholders, the education sector need to be focused to the right and the global standard and the global focus. But still our education sector is running. What exactly is before 1947, the British system they established. Still our education system is running in a certificate form. People are very much curious to get the certificate, whether they are very much curious to know the exact knowledge. So this area, as I experience and I have some good knowledge about the Finland education, maybe there is a very good opportunity to make a good bridging about the Finland and Bangladesh education system. I think if I'm not wrong, the majority of the people, those who are coming from Bangladesh to the Finland, majority of them are coming on the backbone of the educational area. So these people can play a very good role. And a lot of this case study, a lot of this, especially you already mentioned this daycare center or the child care center. And you'll be surprised, in Bangladesh context, our mentality of our people, they don't like to send their kids to any child care or daycare center. They thought that, why I will send them to the daycare or child care center? But it is the need of this present scenario. If the kids are going to the daycare center, they can learn a lot of things. They can learn a lot of the bridging, networking, challenging. So that's why I should say that this is also another area. There's the primary education, secondary education, tertiary education. This all education sector, how need to be transformed to get the best product. Because Bangladeshi people, one of the good thing I should say, the people are really talented. I don't know, maybe God realized that Bangladesh has an unlimited or has limited resources. So God giving the unlimited meritorious people in our country. And I must say that anyone, you talk with the Bangladeshi people and Bangladeshi student, you'll be surprised to see their talent, because they know whole world. And any Bangladeshi people, and you see, in respect of social networking, if you go to the Facebook, Google, everyone is recognized that Bangladeshi people are most talented people, because they can contribute a lot. And even the last few years, Bangladeshi students, they are dominating to the individual outsourcing. We are the number second in the whole world, individual outsourcing. Because in the company-wise, maybe our strength is not too much vibrant. But individually, as I already mentioned, our people are very talented. So if you give them job, if you give them the opportunity, they can prove their efficiency in a lot of areas. So in that context, again, I should say that the people, those who are already even working here in various fields, please come forward. Please try to make bridging in your own domain to make the interaction with the education sector. Maybe as I already talked with the Lisa, I think this Kanish, I should say, that the Kanish, because she is already doing research in the, from the wood, how can the textile, that wood can contribute in the textile sector. I think one of our research area is working from the wood, because as I know, the 74% of Finland is this forest. So that means the Finland has an unbelievable opportunity to produce these sorts of products. Once upon a time, we were pioneering the papers and paper-related products. But you know, because of technological disruption, a lot of change is coming. So that's I'm sure that this is also another opportunity, because you know, Bangladesh is now very focused in the textile industry, and we are fighting for second and third position. Sometimes we are in second, sometimes we are in third. And by virtue of this, our people's merit, I think the textile is now is playing a very good role in our economical development. And you know, this textile, what happened? Because our young people, they are coming frequently to become an entrepreneur. So what happened? This lot of the good entrepreneur, they already developed their entrepreneurial activities through this textile industry. Because Bangladesh has more than 40,000 garments industry. And textile producer and a lot of this back-end, front-end, lot of support is done by the textile industry. So I'm sure there's these sorts of research can easily can collaborate with Bangladeshi textile business community. Because Bangladesh textile community, again, I should say, they are very rich now. And you know that there are a lot of things that the USA, Europe, Bangladeshi textile businessmen, they have a very good role. So this area also we can work very closely one-to-one. And secondly, in another area, in education sector and the young people, where the Finland is also playing a very good role, and we have also some proven track record in the young generation, those who are coming to the startup. You have a very good startup ecosystem developing in the Finland. So Bangladesh is also saying, as I already mentioned, the young people and the talented people of Bangladesh, they are very curious to become an entrepreneur. But a lot of cases, they do not know what exactly the ecosystem they should follow. So this ecosystem is already developed in the Finland. I think the Finland people, as you have the limitation of the population, but we don't have the limitation of the population. And our people, as I already mentioned, we are meritorious. So these people can make a big, good bridging with the Finland startup ecosystem. So what happened is the government is a few years back, government was not very focused about this startup or entrepreneurial activity. But you'll be happy to know that the presently our Prime Minister and all of the government people, they are also very focused now. While I was president in the Dhaka Chamber of Commerce in 2013, I took one initiative to create 2,000 new entrepreneurs. And everyone is laughing. Everyone is surprised how it is possible to create 2,000 entrepreneurs by 1 year. So I am lucky enough, I got very good support from the Bangladesh Central Bank. And luckily, I got the all support from the government. So after establishing this initiative in 2013, I think just for 3 days back, our Honorable Prime Minister, maybe a lot of you may have heard, just 3 days back, 20th August, in the ministerial meeting, the Honorable Prime Minister is already approved 500 crore Bangladeshi taka for the startup initiative. That is, young people, they will get the loan without any collateral, which was one of my findings in 2013. So that's another key area. I'm sure that we can work with the Finland, because as I mentioned again, because Bangladeshi entrepreneur is really doing well, and our economy, you know, this is 1974, 1980, 1999, 1995, 1996. our budget, always we are focusing for the foreign aid. Our government, I think, budget allocation, more than 70% or 60%, government always focus for the foreign aid. Foreign donation, soft loan, lot of these sorts of grant. But nowadays, last 10 years, our government not have a single penny focus for getting the foreign donation or foreign loan. Because all of the money is coming from the internal resources. Because one of the key reasons, our entrepreneurial activity, so the people are giving now tax. You know, there's all of the maximum money in this government gets the direct revenue. And at the same time, as I already mentioned, this is because of this entrepreneurial activity. So revenue focus and revenue collection is going rapidly high. And another successful, you know, that equipment is also going, because a lot of the Bangladeshi, which we love to call non-resident Bangladeshi. You know, there's a lot of the non-resident Bangladeshi are working in the whole world. Especially Middle East country. I think Middle East country is almost, if only the Saudi Arabia, there's a lot of people I talked last few days, and everyone has very good intention to contribute to the society with their own expertise. So everyone is thinking that Bangladesh has some problem, no doubt. But always I love to say this problem is an opportunity for you. If Bangladesh is like as the Finland, I think you don't have any opportunity to do anything in Bangladesh. So I love to say that while I started my business in 1990 after my university graduation, I love to say that I'm really lucky that I'm a Bangladeshi. Because within these 30 years, I developed 45 companies and I developed a lot of these entrepreneurial activities between these times. Because Bangladesh has a lot of problem, at the same time, Bangladesh has a lot of opportunity also to contribute. Because as I saw that yesterday, I think when I visited with Sharif, I think he already showed me the waste management. I think the practice what exactly you do in Finland. I think the same system we can do in Bangladesh. I know a lot of people, you may tell that, no, it takes a lot of time. It's true, it takes a lot of time. Because while I started in 1990, with a very small company, while I started my business, I fight to survive myself, to give my rent to my office, to feeding my staff. But now you see that this 29-year journey or 30-year journey, I run a lot of the company between this time. So that means why? Because the Bangladesh has the problem, at the same time Bangladesh has the opportunity also. So this waste management, energy sector, education sector, IT sector, health sector, these sorts of lot of area you already have, which you can start to work. Please start, if you start in a small way, once upon a time, you will see that your company or your efforts is coming to the very bigger way. But if you think that, oh, there is a lot of problem, then I'm sure that you always prepare yourself to do something better. Maybe at the end of the moment when our life will be finished, because God is already sending us, everyone, we are coming to this world for a limited time. No one will get opportunity to cross the limit. But we don't know what exactly the time is allocated by God to stay in this world. So that is one of the reasons I should expect and appeal to everyone. Please try to start your journey to do something to make the bridging and try to get the practical knowledge from the Finland what exactly you achieved. Because you are lucky enough, you got the opportunity to learn some fantastic technological developing country. That where a lot of the best practices you can replicate to the Bangladesh. As I already mentioned that the waste management, I think one of the machine, maybe one of the recycling factory, I think three or four people, and if anyone is already sending me, I would love to sponsor one unit. Let's show it to Bangladesh. I'm sure that whenever the people will see, because I'm really surprised, the people are coming with a big bag. They are getting the wastage and they put it to the waste machine and they're getting some money. And after the blank bag, they are going to shopping. So again, they are going to the feeding the bag and going to the home. So these sorts of practice we can easily do in Bangladesh. Maybe some people know that Bangladesh is not ready for these sorts of technological developed system. But I'm sure Bangladesh is now is far away from the earlier condition. Day by day, the country is developing. As I already mentioned, because Bangladesh is now not in the early stage. The people, the young people, they have a very good mindset, and the government also have a very good mindset. Everyone is very key and eager to change the country. So considering all of the aspects and all of your distinguished discussion, I'm sure that's It will be good for everyone, especially the BFCC and Green Start. And from my university, I am ready to help you in respect of joint collaboration, in respect of research, because in a lot of countries we already developed some system like foreign student exchange, faculty exchange, and research exchange, especially from Australia and Japan, Malaysia, Korea. These four countries, we are very focused. We already developed some lot of exchanging with our university. So I hope that you will try to start something. And thank you very much, and wish all of you good luck, and thank you for your time.